Where are those northerners who defended government failure and insulted those who criticized the government? Sani, welcome to the news. And please subscribe to our channel. Oh, please permit me to laugh. This laugh that I'm laughing, if I don't laugh, it will choke me. It is not supposed to be funny, but I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry. But I have to. Yes, there are people who, even when people were being slaughtered, children, even you that you were not there, me that I'm a very visual person, anything you tell me, I try to visualize. When I hear that so people were killed, children were involved, pregnant women, I cannot take the images. I was not there. I cannot take the images off my mind. Yeah, these people come and say, oh, this administration is the best. They will come out, and I don't know how love drunken they are with this administration. I don't know how they are so obsessed with these people. They will come out and say, oh, this administration have done the best. In fact, they are the best. And I'm saying, wow, they are the best, really. And people keep dying on a daily basis. They are the best. And people, last year, 2020, in October, people were massacred at Lekki. Till today, the victims have not gotten justice. They are the best, right? I keep saying, if you keep on supporting evil, that means you're congratulating the evil and telling the evil, come to me, and it will happen. It will happen. So these people now, all of a sudden, they are now coming to say, no, they're no longer the best, though. In fact, we are dying, though. Help us. So, like, it is very funny. Even though it is not in a way, but it is funny indeed. Let's find out what Mr. Sanu said. Now the news in detail. Based on that note, the former senator that represented the good people of Kaduna Central Senatorial Zone, Senator Shehu Sanu, decided to speak. While speaking, he made it known that most prominent newspaper in the North wrote in it clearly that life has lost its value in the North under Buhari. Speaking further, he asked a question so as to know where those Northerners who were defending the failure of the government and those who insulted those who criticized the government in the past. His post reads, when the most prominent newspaper from the North had in its editorial that life has lost its value under Buhari's Nigeria, the question is, where are those from the North who defended the failure of the government and insulted all those who criticized or simply advised the government? Indeed, this is terrible. The way people are being killed is very worrisome. At times, one may wonder if we still have leaders in this country. As it stands now, it is only God that can save Nigerians from these terrorists. That is just the truth. That is the truth and nothing but the truth. Let those people come out now. They are not hiding their faces in shame, right? Those people that said that those that were killed in Lekki, the NSAS protests, that there was nothing happened, that in fact, these people, that they were not killed, their bodies cannot be seen. Why we were still thinking about it? Why we are still crying and grieving about it? That if you know that you have a family member, come out. Meanwhile, people came out and they became attacked. One Kamsi Yo, who was a witness all through that year the panel was investigating, she was almost macheted to death. This is the coming out. And others who went there, lawyers that treated the case, and other witnesses have been threatened. You are next. We are coming for you. And you are telling them to come out. Till date, we have not heard anything concerning that issue. Gradually, they will sweep it under the carpet. Are we going to talk about people who are killed? Is it the Chibwa girls? Is it people who are called Tulani? Mother and daughters alike who are continually being raped by the same animals. Do you know that? And yes, these people, just recently, before they were proscribed, they came out and said, hey, these people, they are mere criminals. People who, if you see these people, if you encounter them and you are alive, you cannot get yourself for the rest of your life. Never. You will need to go for therapy. There was a particular article, I think about 5 years ago. Was it 4 years ago? I cannot remember. But anytime I remember what I read in that article, sincerely, I am disturbed. It did not happen to me. I just happened to come across it. A mother and child alike who were almost raped. Like, the trauma can never leave them for life. even at the point where they have left that incident where it happened, they have left Nigeria as a whole. At night, she used to say her daughter will still be shivering. If you meet these people, they are not going to be merciful to you. These people were saying, and what the Nigerian government was saying, they should proscribe them as terrorists. Nigerian army came out and said, oh, that the Nigerian army cannot deal with them because they're not terrorists. Now, they have made them terrorists. Has there been any effect? No. No effect. Nothing at all. Like nothing, nothing, nothing. Nothing has been done. I said it earlier before that these terrorists now, these people that have been proscribed terrorists, that they cannot, even when you proscribe them, nothing, it will not change anything. It will not change anything at all. It is not going to make people come out and, make the Nigerian army come out and do what they are supposed to do. There will still be excuse upon excuse upon excuse. Now, all of a sudden, these people are now coming out to cry. Well, it is better less than never. Now that they have gotten to a point where they need to cry out, I just pray that it yields fruit. I pray that now that the people who are against protests are now leading protests, I pray that it will be useful. So that we are not going to say, so the North can protest and the South will not. Sincerely, with all sincerity, what is going on in the North does not need to happen to anybody. Nobody deserves it. No one. No matter the offense, no one. It has gotten to a point where we all remember that we are Nigerians. Before you became a northerner, you are a human being. These people are humans. These people, they are innocents like you and me. The only crime is being at the wrong place at the wrong time. And that is why some of them are no more. That is why some of them have lost their hands, their legs. Some of them lost family members. Some of them lost everything. Even their sanity. So it is time. Let the Northerners rise up. And I just pray that the Southerners find it in their hearts to forgive them and join them. This is not a battle for them alone. Sincerely, it is not their battle. It is high time we lick our wounds together in this country. Come together and do what? Know that we are not each other's enemy. We are not. It has gotten to the point where we talk to each other. Yes, I offended you in how many years ago? You offended me how many years ago? I forgive you. Let us live in peace. Let us come together with unity. You see the people against us in this country. We can pull them down. We can show them that united is 100 times better than division. On this note, we have come to the end of the news. We say thank you for telling it a lesson until I come your way next time. Enjoy the rest of your day.